Here we have Randolph Ross, third place in the men's 400 meter. And so just start off by talking about how did your run go today, and like, how'd you feel, I guess?
My race didn't really go as planned, but I can't really complain, you know, being able to make the team and have the opportunity to go to the Olympics. So it's just fine tune everything, get ready to go faster at the Olympics.
Was there something specific that went wrong, or is it just the way it was, like, the way it went down?
I think it was just the meets coming back to back, coming off of nationals and running a PR of almost a whole second. So it's just my body recovering and getting ready to hit it hard again the following weekend. So I think it's just everything piled on top of me. But I feel like once I recover and get ready, then I'll be fine.
So we have a question from Sierra Seesock. She said, what would it mean for you and Trevor to hopefully have the opportunity in the semifinals or finals, or both, to run the 4x400 together again in Tokyo?
That's amazing. Coming in, we knew what we could do, and we knew that if we ran our right way, we'll both be able to make it to the Olympics. And it's just a dream having somebody that I've been training with since high school have the same dream as me and make it. It's just crazy.
Do you have a plan for now, between now and Tokyo, to just get ready and recover?
I don't. I kind of just listen to my coach and whatever he says goes. So it's just, if he says recover, recover. If it's time for me to go again, then it's time.
And so I'll wait to see if any media has any more questions. Just raise your hand if you have any more questions as well. Do you have any plans to celebrate making the team at all?
Just not exactly. I'm still in school. I'm in summer school right now and have another class coming up. So it's just get my homework done, be able to graduate early, and then start my career from there.
What was it like to be in such a deep field, and like, was it kind of like overwhelming to be, I mean, even though you had the record already?
It was most definitely different. Like, the whole feeling coming into the meet, like me being so young and like seeing all these people like Michael Cherry, Michael Norman, I used to see them on TV back in high school, like running 43, and I thought it was just amazing. So coming in and being right next to them in the competition, it was a little overwhelming in the beginning, but I just had to calm down, run my race, and do what I do.
So we have a question coming in. Someone's raising their hand. We'll give them one sec to type it out. Still typing. Okay, we have a question from Dennis J. Freeman. He said, Randolph, what does it mean to represent HBCUs?
It's amazing. Coming in, this is not something you see every day. HBCUs, they were always seen as schools without money. Yeah, you have a talented person come out every now and then, but being one of the only colleges to have two people possibly make it to Tokyo is amazing. It's not just me, it's also my teammate Trevor. So it's just, I have all the support behind me. We have family, friends, everybody from the HBCU community is just cheering me on the whole way around. So it's just amazing to see everybody and be able to rep HBCUs the whole way.
And then we have a question from Doug Binder. He said, what was the hardest part going back to back with intense meets like this so far away from home?
Well, I've been up here for almost a month exactly. So it was just coming back off of a 43 that I ran last week. It was kind of hard getting my body back to where it needed to be, because so my body, that was last week, was a peak. And it was like, when you peak, you have to come down. So it was kind of forcing my body to stay up. And the hard part was bouncing back and being able to run these times that I'm gonna have to take in order to qualify. But starting off, the prelims was rough. The semis, I was working back into it. And the final was just whatever was left in the tank.
And then we have a question from Ashley Coleman. She said, we talked last week about the decision to go pro or remain a collegiate athlete. Does the decision still remain as you will compete college?
Yes, I plan to go ahead and get my degree. I'm in summer classes, so hopefully I can finish school a little early. But I still have some bins I gotta finish in college first.
Then we have another question from Doug Binder. He said, if you consider the possibilities being on a 4x400 team with Mike Norman, Cherry, etc., how does that make you feel?
Oof. That's real exciting. Seeing the top people the top people in the nation and the world, and being able to be right beside them, relying on them in a 4x4, that's, I think I'm ready for it.
And then we have another question from Dennis J. Freeman. He said, can you talk about the level of competition at this level compared to the NCAAs?
This is most definitely different. Seeing in college, everybody, you see people with different running styles and the way they get around the track. But in the professional level, it's completely different. Like Michael, for instance, he caught me before we even got to the 200 meter mark. And that was something that I wasn't used to, because in college that hasn't happened. So it's the competition and the level of experience, and the rounds was completely different from what we did last week. And I think as I get older and progress throughout my professional career, I'll get used to it and handle it differently. But it was definitely a big change.
Then we have a question from Taylor Dutch. She said, how does it feel to share this moment with your dad and coach, who is also an Olympian?
Wow. I hadn't thought about that yet. But it's great having somebody that's been there and who has coached me the way, since I've been able to start track about age 8, having him be through everything, know what it's going to be like, and also being able to make the team on Father's Day. It's a great experience and something we probably cherish the rest of our lives.
And then we have a question from Dennis J. Freeman. He said, talk about the presence of North Carolina AT&T at the Olympic trials. Will people pay more attention to your program?
I believe so. Like over the years, we've been a growing program. We've been prospering throughout the years, and we're going to do nothing but get better. Hopefully, this actually shows that our school is ranked higher than most people might see, having two people and not just one make it to the top level of runners. It's, people are going to talk the way they want. They're going to do things the way they see, but when the proof is there, it's there.